The next problem, draw a DFA to accept the language. They have given a language here. Okay, the language is, they have given W, B, A, B. So what does this mean? So here B, initially you have W. So what is this W? W, it belongs to A, B. That is, it can have any number of A's and any number of B's. So what do you mean by star here? It is zero or more occurrence. Okay, if it is plus, it means that epsilon is not accepted. So here the question means star means zero or more occurrence. So I need not have anything here. Okay, I need not have anything, that is epsilon B A B. So what is the base string here? So it is B A B. Okay, obtain a DFA to accept the language W, B, A, B. So in general, I can tell that all the strings ending with B, A, B should be accepted. So this is the base thing. So what are the other possibilities? So it should end with B, A, B. So in the beginning, I can have anything. A, 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 B, A, B. Okay, so at the end, you should have B, A, B. So one more possibility is B, 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 and then B, A, B. So in the beginning, I can have anything. Okay, I can even have the combination as A, B, A, B. Okay, B, A, B. At the end, I should have B, A, B. In the beginning, you can have anything. Okay, so this will be the base condition, B, A, B. So we shall draw a DFA for this. So I'll take one state Q naught. So initially it is B, A, B. So I'll draw one DFA with respect to B, A, B. So I'll take it to one more state, B. I'll take the state as Q1. Next it is A. I'll take the state as Q2. Next I'll take B. I'll take the state as Q3. So initial condition is satisfied. So it can accept a string B, A, B. So it should accept in the sense it should reach the final state here. So I'll make Q3 as a final state. Okay. So one thing is done. So according to the given question, the input, it can be A and B. So from each and every state, I should have one outgoing A and B. So I'll consider Q0. So from Q0, I have a outgoing B, but I don't have outgoing A. So I should consider A and I should link it to some state. So what are the different possibility? A, from Q0, I can take it to Q0 itself. From Q0, I can take it to Q1. From Q0, I can take it to Q2. From Q0, I can take it to Q3. But you should take in such a way that it will not violate this particular condition and it will satisfy other valid condition. So I'll consider this one now. So it should end with B, A, B. So in the beginning, I can have any number of A's. So what I'll do is Q naught, I can have any number of A's. Any number of A's in the sense it is loop, right? So what I'll do, I will just loop it here. So now this particular condition will be satisfied. A, 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 A. Then however, it should end with B, A, B. So B, A, B, it will reach the final state. So this is done. So I'll consider the next one. Next state is Q1. So from Q0, A and B both are done. Next I'll consider Q1. From Q1, I have considered A. Now I should take B. Okay, I should take B. So B, once again, I can loop it to Q1. I can take it to Q2. I can take it to Q3. I can take it back to Q0. So what I'll do is, I'll consider this particular case. B, 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 A, B. So what I'll do, 1B is already read, so it should start from here, right? It will read 1B. Next, what I'll do is, I will loop B here. Okay, that time it becomes B. Any number of B's, okay, any number of B's. Since it is a loop, it can be zero or more occurrences. Okay, it can be zero or more occurrences. So it will be B, any number of B's, and finally it is ending with the last loop will be B, A, B once again. So even this is done. So I'm done with Q0, A, B is done. With respect to Q1 also, A, B is done. Next I'll consider Q2 and then Q3. Okay, I'll consider Q2 and Q3. So from Q2, I have a outgoing B. from Q2 I have outgoing B. Now I should consider A from Q2. So where will I take this Q2? Suppose thing A, okay? So where will I take this A? Suppose thing that I'll take a loop here, okay? I'll take a loop here and name it as A. So in that, if that is the case, what happens? It can be B, A. I can have any number of A's. A, B. Okay? I can have any number of A's. A, B. So what happens? At the end, I will not get this. I will be not getting B, A, B. So I cannot loop A here, since it is violating the condition. So what is the next option? I can take A here. Okay? I can take A here. So if I take here A, what happens once again? It will become B, A and then A. Once again, it will violate the condition. So I can neither loop it here nor I can take it here. I am left with two more options. That is, I can take it back to Q1 or I can take it back to Q0. So if I take it to Q2, what Q1, what happens? Suppose saying that I will take A like this. Okay, if I take A like this, I have a possibility B, A, 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 B. So it means that it will end with A, A, B. So which is once again violating the condition. So I can't take it here. So what is the only option left? The only option left is to take it back to Q0. So from Q2, I'll take it to Q0. I'll take it as A. So now we shall check. So it will be B, A. It will come back to Q0. No matter what it is, since it has reached Q0, to reach Q3, it should pass BAB. So since it is passing BAB, it will satisfy the given condition. Okay, it will satisfy the given condition. So I'll consider this particular example. ABAB BAB. Okay, ABAB BAB. So here you can see A, B, A, B, and AB. Okay, still AB is remaining. This is a valid string, but my DFA, it is not accepting. Okay, my DFA is not accepting this thing. So what I should do? I should modify my DFA. So how can I modify my DFA? Check whether all inputs are done. So here AB is done, BA is done, AB is done, my Q3. So from Q3, I have A and B remaining. So where should I take this AB? So if I loop it here, AB, it is zero or more occurrences, right? It can be only A looping also. So the condition will fail. So I should take it somewhere else. So where can I take it? So what I'll do is A and B. See, it is B here. Okay, B here. I need a string ending with BAB. Okay, BAB. So what I'll do is A, B, this one. A, B, A, B. I need a AB again. So what I'll do? I will get it back here. Okay, I'll get it back to this particular position. So no matter what it is, once it reaches here, if it needs to come back to this position, it should traverse through Q2 again. So B, A, B, B, A, B. So I'm done with this. So A is done. Next you have to consider B. So where will I take this B? So if I get B here, so what happens? It will be B, 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 B. So it will end with B, A, B, which will violate the condition. So I need B, A, B, right? So A, B is here. So what I'll do, I will take B here. Okay. So once it reaches here, I can come back to this particular state Q1. So B, A, B. So it is a valid DFA for the given language. Next problem, draw a DFA to accept strings of A's and B's with the substring AAB. So in the previous problem, the string should end with B, a string should end with BAB. So here it is substring AAB. That is, initial condition is AAB. Okay, even this is accepted. So in the beginning also I can have anything. At the end also I can have anything. So substring AAB. So AAB is the basic condition. So in the beginning I can have anything. At the end I can have AAB. Okay? Or in the beginning I can have AAB. In the end I can have anything. Or in the beginning I can have anything. In between I should have AAB. And at the end I can have anything. So these are the different possibilities. No matter what you take, substring, it should consist of a substring AAB either in the beginning, at the end or in between. So since this is the base condition, we shall draw a DFA for AAB first. So I'll take start. I'll take a state Q naught. I'll consider A. So it goes to next state Q1. I'll consider the next A. It goes to state Q2. I'll take the next B. It goes to state Q3. So this is a valid string. So this becomes the accepting state. So I'll make this as the final state. Okay, I'll make this as a final state. So this is done. AAB is done. AAB is done. Okay. So now from every state, you should see whether you have one outgoing A and outgoing B. Okay. So I'll consider this particular condition now. AAB. Okay. So in the beginning, I can have AAB and at the end, you can have anything. Okay. In the end, you can have any number of A's, any number of B's, or you can have a combination of A and B. So what I'll do is, I will simply loop it here. Okay. So from state Q3, both A and B is done. That is, at the end I can have anything. Okay. So this is done. Next we have to check these two things. Okay. So it should end with AAB, or in between I can have AAB. So from Q naught, A is done. Okay. So from Q naught, A is done. I should take B. Okay, so where will I take B to? So this is AAB. In the beginning, I can have any number of B's, right? I can have B, 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 and then I can have AAB. So what I'll do, since I can have any number of B's here, I will simply loop it. Okay, so I can have any number of B's, and then it will end with AAB. So I'm done with Q naught. Next, I'll consider Q1. Okay, I'll consider Q1. So what condition can I take? So here A is done. Next I should consider B. So from Q1, A is done, B. So I can take a string as A. I can have B, 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 B. Okay. I can have B, 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 B. And then A, B. So if I take a loop here, what happens? I have an A, any number of B's and then A, B. So the string will end with A, B. But I want my string to end with AAB. So I cannot loop it here. So what I will do, I will get it back to state Q0. So now what happens? I can read one A, B. I can read any number of B's now. Once I am done with this, then once again it is AAB. So from Q0, A and B is done. From Q1 also, A and B is done. Next from Q2. So from Q2, B is considered. I have to consider A. Okay, I should consider A now. So where should I take A? So A, I can have AA. I can have any number of A's. Okay, I can have any number of A's, but it should end with B. Okay, I can have A, 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 and then B. So at the end, I'll be having B itself. Then AA, and before also, I can have any number of A's here. So what I'll do? I will loop A here. That time I can have one possibility as A, 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 B. A, A, and then B. Okay. So I have outgoing variable A, B from each and every state. So DFA is done here. The next problem, draw DFA to accept strings of zeros and ones. So far you have taken A's and B's, now it is zeros and ones. Having three consecutive zeros. So it is similar to previous problem. Okay, it is similar to previous problem itself. So in previous problem they told it as substring AAB. Here they have told it as 3 consecutive zeros. So what does it mean? It means that it has a substring 0, 0, 0. That's it. Okay. So here substring will be 0, 0, 0. So this is the base condition now. Draw a DFA to accept strings of zeros and ones having 3 consecutive zeros. So this is the base condition 0, 0, 0. Then like previous problem, you can have any condition. So in the beginning, I can have anything and it can end with 0, 0, 0. Or it can start with 0, 0, 0, later it can have anything. Or in the beginning, it can have anything. In between, you can have 0, 0, 0 and then it can end with anything. Okay, it is similar to previous problem itself, but there it was AA and B. So last string was different, here it is same. So first we shall draw the DFA for this base condition. That is start. I'll take a state Q naught. Okay. So from Q naught, I'll take a variable input alphabet 0. Okay, 0. It will go to state Q1. From Q1, I'll take the input 0 again. It will go to state Q2. So from Q2, I'll take 0, that is Q3. So 0, 0, 0 is done. This is a valid string, okay, according to the given language. So this becomes the accepting state. That is, it is a final state. So this is done. Next, I will consider other possibilities. So I should have 0, 0, 0. And then I can have anything in the beginning or at the end. So my string consists of zeros and ones, right? So from Q naught, I have taken 0. From Q naught, I should consider 1 now. Where will I take this 1? So according to this, in the beginning, I can have any number of ones, end it with 0, 0, 0. So what I will do? I will simply loop 1 here. Okay, I will simply loop 1 here. So 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, then end it with 0, 0, 0. Since it is substring, once you have 0, 0, 0, at the end you can have anything. Okay, at the end you can have anything. So what I will do, I will loop it here. Okay, I will loop it here. I will take the inputs 0 and 1. So start it with 0, 0, 0. At the end I can have anything. That is 0, 0, 0. Beginning is 0, 0, 0. At the end I can have anything. So this one and this one, you have different possibilities. Okay, you have different possibilities. Here I can have anything. So one possibility is this that I consider, starting with 1 and then 0, 0, 0. I can have a combination like 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. Okay, I can have alternative 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0 and then end it with 0, 0, 0. So we shall check whether I have that particular possibility. 1, 0, I should have once again 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, alternative 1, 0, but it should end with 0, 0, 0. So if I take 1 here, okay, suppose think that I will take loop here and I'll take it as 1. So if that is the case, what happens? It will start 0, I can have 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. So what does it mean? It ends with 1, 0, 0. Okay, so that can't happen. I can't take a loop here. I should come back to 0 itself so that I will get 0, 0, 0 again. So instead of taking a loop here, what I'll do? I'll get it back to Q naught. Okay, so now you can see that you can have alternative values. See, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Okay, so no matter how many values you have, since it comes back to Q naught, it will end with 0, 0, 0 itself. Okay, later once again you can have anything. So from Q naught I have 0 and 1. From Q1 I have 0 and 1. From Q3 I have 0 and 1. From Q2 I have only 0. So now I should consider 1 from Q2. So if I take a loop here, what happens again? It can be any number of ones ending with 0. So I can't do that. Q2, I cannot take it to last state also. So what happens? 0, 0, 1. Even that is not possible. So I cannot go further. I should come back itself. So what I will do? I will get it back to Q1. So 1, if I get it back to Q1, what happens? It will be 0, 0, 100. So once again, you are not getting 30. So what I should do? I should get it back to Q naught. And I'll take the input as 1. So it is 00. It will be 1 0 1 0, any combination, but it will end with 0 0 0 itself. So this is the DFA that you have got considering these conditions. Now you can take different possibilities and check whether it is valid or not. So once again, for each and every problem considering 5 tuples, you should write the deterministic FSM.